as though it was ages ago when Box Elder football players came together during the first week of August to begin official practice for the 1995 football season. But the aches and pains of that first week were soon forgotten as team coaches and players got closer to that first game, a home opener against the Spanish Fork Dons, the Friday before school started. Just about the only black spot fans could find was a preseason poll of Region 5 coaches, which saw Logan picked to win the league championship, with Box Elder tabbed to finish in fourth place behind the Grizzlies, Mountain Crest, and Bear River. And what some would say was a prophetic quote, he had coach Wes Raceless said, "I really think our kids are better than that." Little did he know.
Crystal, the Box Elder Bees are the Class 4A state champions, their first title since 1960, and now they really storm the field. To the students from Box Elder, there's nothing but a mass of purple down there at the midfield stripe.
Spanish Fork came to town August the 25th, but were sent back to Utah County nursing their wounds after being stung by the bees 56-22. Many fans thought to themselves, well, yeah, but how good are the bees really? It would turn out that the Dons were one of the four best teams in the 4A ranks, and the bees would face them again late in the season. Running back Phil Haywood scored three rushing touchdowns as he collected 126 yards on 13 carries. Pete Levitt scored twice, and Ben Huff and Mike Sumko each caught a TD pass. B quarterback Mark Dunn gave fans and coaches alike a scare in the second quarter when he limped off the field with what was feared to be a broken big toe. Dunn had already completed 6 of 7 passing for 91 yards and a touchdown. The toe injury turned out to be not so serious, but Dallas Tyler played most of the rest of the game, collecting a TD pass himself. The offensive player of the game was Brian Stender, offensive left guard, while Caleb Mathis had three tackles, a hurry, and a block kick to be named offensive player of the game. The Bees travel just 20 minutes south to face the Weber High School Warriors. The Warriors, who eventually would post their best record in many years, handed the Bees a 20-6 loss. A loss that would turn out to be the only defeat the Bees would suffer in 1995. The Warriors came out fast, scoring twice in the first quarter before many fans had settled in their seats. Weber led 13-0 when the Bees finally got on the scoreboard. But Weber scored again near the end of the first half, and neither team could do much the second half. The defensive player of the game was Josh Hudson, who had 5 tackles, an assist, and a deflection from his defensive back position. The offensive honor went to tackle Ryan Whitaker, who graded out 20 more points than anyone else on the offensive line. Mike Sumpco also had 6 pass receptions. The Bees had one more practice game to play. This one, another home game, where they hosted the Payson Lions. This time, Box Elder got back on track and claimed a 35-14 win. Payson took the opening kickoff and marched right down the field for 6 points, but it would be their only TD until late in the fourth quarter. The Bees took the kickoff and marched down the field for a score of their own, and eventually would tally 15 points in the first quarter. The Bees got another 14 in the second quarter to post a 29-7 halftime lead. The team got one more in the third quarter to make the score 35-7. Haywood gained 112 yards on 14 carries and had a touchdown to be named the offensive most valuable player. But Coach Raisler had praise for other members of the offensive unit. Mark Dunn had 4 complete passes for 148 yards and gained 53 yards rushing. He also scored twice. Mike Sumpco caught 3 of those passes for 146 yards and also had a touchdown. And 4 offensive linemen graded out at 80% or better. They were Nate Putnam, Brian Stender, Ryan Whitaker, and Kevin Jensen. Jake Anderson was the player of the game on defense as he collected 5 tackles and a sack. Casey Munns had 11 tackles in 4 hurries, while Kurt Anderson and Jeremy Barber each had an interception. Bobcats were next on the menu for the touchdown-hungry Bees. And the Bobcats watched the Bees to leave Smithfield with a 38-23 victory. After the game, Coach Raisler said this was the best effort he had seen the Bees make since coming to Box Elder. The team scored on its first possession and never looked back. Dunn was named the offensive player of the game, and he was 7 for 10 passing for 152 yards and 3 touchdowns. He also rushed for 20 yards and continued to be over 50% in his passing. Haywood rushed 18 times for 175 yards and scored once as the Bees gained 317 yards on the ground. Nate Davis had 8 tackles to be named defensive player of the game, while kicker Matt Peebly kicked 5 straight PATs and added a 37-yard field goal to be named the ace of the special team. Thank you. The Bees face their first challenge of the season, playing the Logan Grizzlies in the annual Box Elder homecoming game. The Grizz had been ranked number one in the state just the week before and were ranked number four at kickoff time. But the Bees rose to the challenge to pin a 38-20 defeat on the Grizzlies. That after trailing 14-0 just 4 seconds into the second quarter. After Logan scored its second touchdown, the Bees woke up and scored 4 touchdowns in the next 7 minutes. They'll take a 26-14 lead into the halftime. The Bees would score twice in the second half, while the Grizzlies could muster just one more score. Mark Dunn was once again the offensive player of the game, as he was 7-for-13 yards passing for 183 yards and 4 touchdowns. Josh Hotson was the defensive most valuable player, as he had 6 tackles, a sack, a fumble recovery, an interception, and a deflection. Now the Bees had to deal with Mountain Crest, a team that had posted 6 straight victories over Box Elder. And although it wasn't easy, the Bees claimed a 28-18 win over the Hiram team. The Bees had 331 rushing yards, 125 yards passing, and the defense came up with 5 interceptions, including 3 by Jeremy Barber. I guess since he, Barber, is so small, they would pick on him. But that was their mistake, said Coach Raisler. For his efforts, Barber was named Defensive Player of the Game. Ryan Whitaker was named the Offensive Player of the Game for the second time, as he received a 90% grade for his blocking work. Ben Huff was the A Special Teams Player of the Game, as he punted 3 times for a 42.3-yard average. None of his punts were returned. For the evening, Haywood had 155 yards rushing, and Deacon chalked up 153. In the next two games, the Bees put on awesome displays of offensive firepower. First came Ogden High School, a team that was 2-1 at the time, including a victory over Logan. But the Bees totally humiliated the Tigers by a score of 57-0. Then came Ben Lomond, who also fell by a humiliating 68-13 score. That meant the Bees' offense scored 125 points in two games. In the Ogden game, Haywood once again was named the offensive player of the night. He rushed 17 times for 184 yards and two touchdowns. He had the most complete game of any back I've ever seen, Raisler said. Senior defensive tackle Mike Antonio had six tackles and a 67% grade to be named defensive MVP. Kevin Jensen, playing on special teams for the first time this year, had four tackles on kickoffs to be named the special teams ace of the game. The Ben Lomond game featured more of the same. Brandon Nelson had 11 tackles, a fumble force, and a deflection to claim defensive MVP honors. Casey Munns had 13 tackles, a fumble force, and a deflected pass. Sumko caught four passes for 160 yards and two touchdowns to be named the MVP on offense. Kurt Anderson was the special team's ace of the game as he had excellent runs on kickoffs, including an 88-yarder for a touchdown in the third quarter. Although the Bees had to have the Bear River game in the back of their mind, they played like there was no tomorrow. We'll be right back.
biggest game of Box Elder in the last 5-6 years. You got four things at stake here. Number one seed, region championship, Spike, and now possibly number one in the state since West got beat. Hope we're ready to play.
Where these guys operate. Ball on the right hash mark, headed from our left to our right toward the south end zone. Rolling is done. Dunn going long down the left sideline. Got a man wide open. It's caught. Has jumped over to the 20. He's to the 15. He's to the 10. He keeps his feet. And he's gone. Russ, and he is sacked. He got sacked. And Nate Putnam
is offensively, it's going to be the challenge. I don't think they can stay with our offense. We've got too many guns. We've got the best quarterback in the state, in my opinion. If we can keep between the guards taken care of and keep the tight end from getting loose up the middle, I don't think they'll be able to score on us at all.
Bear River. This was the game of the year for both teams, and many fans came away saying they had just seen the state championship game. As for the Bees, they came away with a 33-30 victory and the Golden Spike Trophy for the first time in 3 years. An estimated 8,000 spectators watched the two Box Elder County teams duke it out, with the outcome not assured until the final gun sounded. The Bears were looking to make their winning streak go to 3, while the Bees were looking for the spike, and especially a 6-0 undefeated record in Region 5. The Bees had come from behind, the score with just 21 seconds left in the game, to clinch their first perfect region season since 1981. Early on, it looked as though the Bees were in a generous mood as they turned the ball over 3 times in the first quarter. But the Bears couldn't take full advantage of the miscues, and ultimately it cost them the game.
Wide to the right. Curtis in the backfield. Fake handoff play action. Resets the pocket, dumps it off to the right side. It's caught down the sideline. He goes. Now they're going to have to try to play lateral, as Turnus is just running around trying to find some place to go. The clock has run out. Turnus is still on his feet looking for some place to go, and he is finally out of bounds in midfield. It's over. As the Bears and the Bees put on what has truly been the Region 5 and Class 4A game of the year in the regular season. Time ran out on Bear River. Box Elder 33 and Bear River 30, as the field is found by a bunch of happy Box Elder fans.
Victory gave the Bees a home field advantage as they hosted Cypress in the first round of the playoffs. The Bees stopped the Pirates 34-17 to advance to the quarterfinals. Tom Harper was named the offensive player of the game as he received a grade of 88% for his efforts. Casey Munns recorded 11 unassisted tackles and was named defensive player of the game. Ben Huff averaged 47 yards on his punt and was named a special teams player. Dunn was 5-for-11 for passing for 121 yards and a TD. As usual, Shumko caught the majority of Dunn's tosses, this time 4-for-109 yards and a TD. We'll be right back. The next week's quarterfinal game saw the Bees host the Murray Spartans, who featured running back C.J. Davis. The Bees won the game 24-20 despite Davis gaining nearly 400 yards rushing. Josh Deacon gained 41 yards and scored a touchdown to be named Offensive Player of the Game, while Mike Antonio had 10 unassisted tackles and 7 assisted to be named Defensive Player of the Game. Matt Peebly kicked 4 passes, and Ben Huff averaged 44 yards punting to share 8 special team honors.
Deja vu all over again the next week as the Bees travel to Romney Stadium on the campus of Utah State University for the 4A semifinal game against Spanish Fork. Box Elder awed the big crowd, most of them from Brigham City, with another offensive show, clobbering the Dons by a 54-26 score, almost identical to the opening game of the season score. On the day, Haywood gained 199 yards on 21 carries, while Josh Deacon tallied 130 yards on 11 carries. Dunn was 5-for-16 for 76 yards. The entire offensive line was named the offensive player of the game. Linemen are Richard Watson, Stender, Harper, Jensen, and Whitaker. Junior linebacker Casey Munns had 14 tackles, an interception and a deflection to be named offensive player of the game. John Mallon, who had 4 tackles on kickoffs, was named a special teams player of the game. On the day, the team scored 8 touchdowns, 6 rushing and 2 on pass interceptions.
High, coming off a state record 20 straight losing season, is in the state finals for the first time since winning the title in 1974. The crushing Leopard defense, led by Jason Capuzzi, has held opponents to just over 14 points per game. But the sting of the Box Elder Bee has been felt by all 10 4A opponents this year. The potent offense, led by Phil Haywood, is averaging nearly 40 points per game. The immovable Leopards against the unstoppable Bees. It's the Utah High School Activities Association First Security Bank Class 4A State Football Championship.
It's a gorgeous day for football at Rice Stadium, and coming your way, the first of today's doubleheader high school football action. Our first game, the 4A state championship between the East High Leopards and the Box Elder Bees. Good afternoon, everyone. Dave Fox along with David James. Reese Stein is down on the field. A couple of newcomers, at least recent newcomers, to the state championship. Sort of a back to the future. We haven't seen either of these teams in this game in a long time.
Box Elder and East have combined to win 20 state titles, but East's last championship was in 74. Box Elder, 1960.
Great matchup, too. When you look at, you know, Box Elder's got a great offense. East has a great defense. Something's got to give here.
East only gives up 14 points a game, but Box Elder, they're like a whack team. They average 39 points a game.
The Colonel likes to hang out in the trenches. He's down on the field now. Reese, nice day for football.
Where else would you want to be at a high school football game than here on the sidelines, David? I tell you, what a great day for a football game. Let's do two, and we will. And what a contrast, what a difference a year makes. Remember last year, of course, you guys were up in the booth where it was warm and dry, but down here on the field, I had every piece of clothing I owned on. There was snow in the stands, ice on the field. It was absolutely brutal. Not today. There's no ice. There's not even any AstroTurf. We're playing on the new sport turf here, and we're just about ready to go. East and Box Elder for the 4A title, Dave.
It's the first of two games coming your way from Rice Stadium. We'll have kickoff of the 4A championship coming up next. Down, they need four. Bauman to throw. Intercepted. Caleb Mathis. And our first turnover of the game, and Box Elder. You know, one thing, East wanted
points on us, and that was our worst defensive effort of the year. Here's the option. They don't defend it well. They do not want to face this option. They don't want to give up the big plays. They know they're going to give up first plays.
24 yards for number 24, and now it's number 32, Phil Haywood. Touchdown, Bees. But this kick by Matt Pebley is good. And the Bees have gone up 10-0.
Just 14 total minutes in the entire game. In that 14 minutes, the team rolled up 493 yards rushing and another 110 yards passing to amass 51 points. Second half, the Bees scored four times on just seven plays. The defense gave up 28 points, but spent much of the afternoon on the field because the offense scored so quickly every time it touched the ball. East literally could not stop the Bee running game. Dunn only threw four passes on the whole afternoon, completing two of them to Sumko, including an 86-yard bomb in the third quarter. Phil Haywood rushed for 279 yards, and Josh Deacon racked up 169 rushes, with Haywood being named offensive MVP. Caleb Mathis played the game of his life, nabbing an interception, fumble recovery, and numerous solo tackles to be named defensive MVP. And Matt Peabody kicked six straight extra points and set a new school record for the most PATs in a season with 53. He was the eighth special teams MVP. You keep on shouting, you keep on shouting.
my dues. Time after time, I've done my sentence, but committed no crime. And bad mistakes, I've made a few.
B's set a team record with the most yards rushing in a game, 493, and the most yards rushing in a season, 3,697. The team also set a record for the most interceptions in a game with 5 on September the 9th at Mountain Crest. Peewee set the PAT record while Haywood piled up 1,955 yards rushing for the season. Haywood's rushing total against East was also a box elder record. Haywood averaged over 9 yards per carry for the season. Also scored 20 rushing touchdowns to complete more records. He also had 7 consecutive 100-yard rushing games and had 10 for the year. Mark Dunn threw 21 touchdown passes on the season, including 4 against Logan on September the 22nd. Mike Sumko caught 16 of those TD tosses and had 1,187 receiving yards for the year. And Ben Huff had the longest punt with a 62-yarder against Payson on September the 8th. Mark Dunn was named the 4A Player of the Year, and he was joined on the All-State team by Haywood, Sumko, Huff, Stender, Putnam, and Casey Mark. Second team was Josh Hudson. All Region 5 honors went to Mark Dunn, Ryan Whitaker, Brian Stender, Mike Antonio, Mike Sumko, Phil Haywood, Nate Putnam, and Casey Mark. Perhaps Raisler summed up the season and predicted the future when he addressed a huge crowd at the county courthouse after the state title game. I know that the team and coaches have been treated so well by the students and the community. The celebration put on by Mayor Clark Davis and Principal J.C. Stewart were just great. We'll remember this for 35 years. But it won't be another 35 years before we win another state championship, the coach promised. Way to go, Bees! Yeah.